Hey, Peter. All of my email is currently on my iMac, but I'd like to be able to check my email from either my iMac, MacBook, or iPhone. What can I do so I can access my mail from any of them?
Well, it's important to first understand the options. Today, there are two popular email access protocols, POP3 and IMAP4.
I know I should know this, but what does protocol mean?
A protocol is a set of rules governing the exchange or transmission of data electronically between devices. In this case, it describes the exchange between your email program and the server. POP3 is an acronym for Post Office Protocol version 3. The way POP works is similar to an actual post office. Incoming messages are delivered to the post office, you go there to get your mail, and the post office does not keep a copy. Since the server does not keep your email, your mailboxes and messages are available only from the computer where you access your email. POP3 is a very simple download and delete protocol. IMAP4 is an acronym for Internet Message Access Protocol, version 4. The way IMAP works is similar to voicemail service. Voicemail is stored on a central system, which you can access from multiple locations. Until messages are deleted, they can be accessed from anywhere. IMAP4 is a more advanced and capable email access protocol than POP3.
So, in what circumstances would I choose POP?
I'd recommend choosing POP in very select situations. Your email provider only offers POP. Some simply don't offer IMAP as an option. If you access your email from a single system, and you have a working backup of that system, I'd recommend choosing IMAP in all other circumstances.
What are some of the benefits of IMAP?
IMAP was designed to allow email clients to access, organize, and manipulate messages on a server. It also provides the capability for an email client to resynchronize its messages with the server, which means if you sort your messages with IMAP, all your other systems will mirror those changes the next time they access your email. To me, the greatest advantage is that, with IMAP, messages remain on the email server until you move or delete them. Should something happen to your Mac, you'll continue to have a copy of your email on the server. Additionally, IMAP can selectively download portions of messages. For example, download the message text first and then the attachments. In this example, we're downloading the same messages via POP on the left and IMAP on the right. With POP, you must download the entire message with all attachments or nothing at all. Since the first two messages have large attachments, I must wait for those to load before I can even see the last message. With IMAP, all the message headers and text are downloaded first, and the attachments are downloaded after. If you access the internet via dial-up or another slow network connection, this could save time if you're sent large attachments. Most email providers will limit the amount of email stored on the server using POP or IMAP. This limit is called a quota. If you exceed your quota, the email provider may stop accepting email for you. We'll discuss solutions for this issue in a future episode. Several years ago, support for using IMAP when disconnected from the internet was quite poor. Today, with modern email clients such as Apple Mail, if you synchronize your account with the server before disconnecting from the network, using IMAP offline is comparable to POP.
How can I tell if I'm using POP or IMAP to access my email?
Open Mail, then choose Preferences from the Mail menu, and then click Accounts. If POP appears below the account description in the sidebar, you're using POP to access your email.
Okay, I'm ready. What do I need to do to switch to IMAP?
First, contact your email service provider and ask if they support accessing email via IMAP. You'll need to ask for the IMAP server address and any other configuration specifics. In some cases, the POP server and IMAP server addresses are the same. To switch from POP to IMAP, we'll be performing the following steps. We'll configure Mail to stop retrieving messages with the POP account. We'll add the new IMAP account. Then we'll set up some special mailboxes. We'll move messages from the POP account to the IMAP account. And finally, we'll disable the POP account. Let's configure Mail to stop retrieving messages with the POP account. Choose Preferences from the Mail menu, and then click Accounts. Select the POP account, and then click Advanced. Deselect Include when automatically checking for new mail. Choose Right Away from the pop-up menu. Click the Remove Now button. This will remove the duplicate copies of messages from the POP server. Click the Remove button. Close the Mail Preferences window and save changes to the POP account when prompted. Now let's add the new IMAP account. Choose Add Account from the File menu. Type your email address and password, then click Continue. Choose IMAP from the Account Type pop-up menu. Type a description and then enter the IMAP server address provided by your email provider. Click the Continue button. From the Outgoing Mail Server pop-up menu, choose the same server as your POP account. Click the Continue button. Review the account summary and then click Create. Now let's set up some special mailboxes. Notice the new IMAP account section in the mail sidebar. Click the disclosure triangle to reveal its contents. When checking email using this account's webmail interface, these folders are used for sent and trash messages. We need to tell mail to use these mailboxes so mail in the webmail interface match. Select the sent folder, then choose mailbox, use this mailbox for sent. Now repeat with the trash folder. Select the trash folder, then choose mailbox, use this mailbox for trash. Next, let's move all the messages from the POP account to the IMAP account. Select the POP account inbox, then choose Select All from the Edit menu. Drag these messages from the POP inbox to the IMAP inbox. Notice the Mail Activity section in the Mail sidebar. You can monitor the progress as mail uploads each message to the IMAP server. Select the IMAP inbox and notice that all the messages have been moved. It's finally time to disable the POP account. Choose Preferences from the Mail menu and then click Accounts. Select the POP account and then click Advanced. Deselect Enable this account. Close the Mail Preferences window and save changes to the POP account when prompted. Here's some useful tips. Not all of the IMAP activity is shown in the Mail Activity section of the sidebar. To see more detail about what mail is doing, choose Activity from the Window menu. Also, to read your messages when offline, choose Synchronize All Accounts from the Mailbox menu before disconnecting from the network. In summary, with IMAP, since all of your email messages and mailboxes are mirrored on the email server, you're better protected should anything happen to your Mac. You can easily manage your email from multiple systems faster and more efficiently. If your email provider doesn't support accessing email via IMAP, you should consider switching to one who does.
Thanks, Peter.
If you have any feedback on this episode, please visit askthemacguy.com and share your thoughts. Thanks. This episode made possible by Speakeasy. Go to speakeasy.net/speedtest to test your internet connection speed. When you decide to switch to Speakeasy, let them know I sent you and you'll save up to $100.